The standard doughnut chart in Excel looks like this. Could we get a version that looks like this? I'll show you two ways. Some time ago, I got an email from Sam asking if I could create this doughnut chart with rounded edges in a dynamic way. While his email was sitting in my inbox, Sam was at work trying to figure this out on his own. On my flight back from the Amsterdam Excel Summit, I was trying to find a solution. When I got home, I sent him my solution, he sent me his version. I'm gonna show you both. Here's my version for creating the progress circle chart with rounded edges in Excel. What we need is to input the percentage, so that's percentage completed for our task, and here we're gonna prepare the data for the chart. So that's going to be equal to this one, and the remainder is going to be 1 minus the percentage completed number. Now all we have to do is select our data, go to insert and insert a doughnut chart. So it's right there where the pie charts are. On the bottom you have the doughnut chart, click on it and we have it here. Let's make some adjustments to it, remove the legend, add a title, take away these borders right here, so these white lines. Click on the series, go to format, from shape outline, select no outline. Now let's also adjust the colors. So this is the remainder series. I want this to be light gray. So click and click again to only select this series. Then go to shape fill and go with a light gray color. For the second series, I want it to be a blue color. So click and click just to select the series. Go to shape fill and select the color that you want. So now we have our progress chart. Let's also add in the input percentage to the middle before we deal with these rounded edges. Now here's a tip. If you want to add in additional information to your chart and you want it to be embedded in the chart so that every time you move your chart around, that other information comes with it, you need to select your chart first and then go to insert and insert the shape or the text box that you want. So I'm gonna click on text box, click somewhere inside my chart, and then immediately go to the formula bar, type in an equal, and select the cell you have the percentage in. So now check this out. Every time I move my chart, that other object, that text box, comes with it. I don't have to group these two different objects together. Now all I have to do is adjust it. So let's make this bigger. Let's also adjust the font type and adjust the color to match our percentage completed series. Now it's just a matter of placing it in the right place, and we already have our progress circle chart. Now let's take care of the edges here. Now my way to making this round with the least amount of effort is to use borders for this. So just select the series, double click it to make sure you only select that series, bring up the chart options. You can use Control 1 or with double click, you can bring it up as well. Go to fill options here. Under border, add a solid border that's the same color as the series and make it a lot thicker. So I'm gonna go with 13 in this case and press enter. Now this does look bulky, doesn't look really neat. To make sure we get this looking a bit more elegant, let's go to the series options here and increase the doughnut hole size to the max. This gives our chart a neater look, but this part, the remainder series, looks super skinny. So we're gonna adjust it by double clicking it, go to the fill options here, add a solid border to this, again the same color as the original series, which was gray, and make this thicker. And in my case, I made it thinner than the other series, just to make sure that the percentage completed series stands out a bit more. But it's up to you, you can adjust it as you see fit. That's our progress circle chart with rounded edges that are a bit round, but they're not as round as maybe we'd like. That's what we're going to cover in the second version. But before I get there, let's do our testing. I'm going to increase the percentage to 70%, that expands, 100%, all good. Now, if you want to change the angle of percentage completed series, you can do that from the series options here by adjusting the angle of the first slice. Now, let's take a look at Sam's version, which has perfectly rounded circles for the edges. Here's Sam's completed version for the progress circle chart. Take a look at the edges. They're perfectly rounded. But now take a look at the data preparation table. It takes a bit more work than our version to set it up. But once you do that, you have these perfect edges in there. Let's set it up together. This part of the doughnut chart is identical to what we did before. So up to this point, we've just added a simple doughnut chart here, and we did the same adjustments that we did in version 1. Now we need to bring in the rounded edges. These are basically two points. So the series is a scatter plot series that we're adding to this. And the two points are going to sit on the edges here. Point number one is going to be up here. Point number two is going to be down here. So point number one is always going to be fixed, right? And Sam has fixed it with an X of 0 and a Y of 1. So 0 is going to be somewhere here in the middle, and 1 is going to be up here. Now, for the second point, that's the difficult part, because what we have to do is find the exact point on the circle that's associated with this percentage. So notice what Sam has done. He's used the sine function together with the pi function and the percentage to calculate the x value associated with the second point. And for the y value, he's used the cosine function together with pi and the percentage to get the exact y position for the second point. Now, to make sure that these points are really sitting in the exact same place, we have to fix the diameter of the circle, which means we need to fix our axis. So let's go and set this up together. Once we have our points calculated, we need to bring them in our chart. So let's right mouse click, select data, add. For series name, let's go with endpoints, and for series values, we only get to add one of these, because at this point, Excel doesn't know that we want to insert a scatter plot. It thinks we want to create another doughnut chart. So I'm going to give it these Y values for now, and later we're going to give it the X values once we've transferred this into a scatter plot. So let's go with OK and OK. Now the next thing we need to do is to change the series chart type. So right mouse click on any of these series, select change series chart type, and we want to change the endpoints to a scatter plot. Now one of these need to be plotted on the secondary axis. So let's plot this one on the secondary, and let's plot our scatter plot on the primary. Scroll down to get to the scatter plot, select it, and then click on OK. So notice we see the two points right here. Now our two points are not floating on the same place yet, because we still have to make some adjustments. One adjustment is we haven't given it the X values yet. So right mouse click, go to select data, select endpoints, and add in the X values, which are these, and OK, and OK. So that was adjustment number one. Adjustment number two is to adjust the axis. If we're fixing Y to be 1, our maximum needs to be slightly higher than 1. This is going to make sure that that point is in the middle of the edge of our percentage completed series. And for the x-axis, we have to use the same numbers. If we want 0 to be in the middle, we need to adjust our maximum and minimum numbers accordingly as well. So let's start with the x-axis. Just select it, go to axis options here, add a minimum and maximum for this. So what Sam chose was -1.15, and for the maximum 1.15, and press enter. This makes sure that that point is now sitting in the middle of our circle. So let's go and adjust the Y as well. So select the Y axis, and we're going to set the same minimum and the same maximum. Notice what happened to our point. It's sitting right in the middle of the edge of our percentage completed, and the second point is sitting in the perfect position. So now all we have to do is to make this marker match our other series. So select the markers, go to fill options, go to marker options, go to built-in. For me, it's already on the circle, so let's just adjust the size, and I'm gonna go with 30 and press enter. Now that looks like it's the perfect size. So let's take away the border of this and adjust the fill color to be a solid fill. That's the same color as our series. That's our progress circle chart with perfectly rounded edges. Let's just remove the grid lines, remove the axes, and test this out. So let's change this to 60%. Looks great. 100%. Perfect. What's your favorite version? Or do you have an alternate method for getting the round edges? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you, Sam, for sharing your version with all of us. Feel free to download the workbook. Link is below the video. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to improve your Excel skills, consider subscribing to this channel.